Hello everyone. In this video, we'll be looking at how to change a WAN interface into a LAN interface and a LAN into a WAN on your Comset router. This method will work on the Comset CM685V-1, V4, V6 and VX routers, as well as the CM770, CM820 and CM950 routers. For this video, I'll be using the CM950 router, which has just one WAN port and two fast Ethernet and 2 gigabit Ethernet LAN ports. So it's four LANs. First, let's look at how to change a WAN interface into a LAN. This is something you might want to do if you don't need a connection to another network, like the NBN. Or maybe the router is somewhere where there is no access to another network, like on a boat. Then there's no need to have a WAN port and it would be a lot more useful to have an extra LAN. Having an extra LAN port will allow you to connect more devices to your router. So you can have up to 5 IP cameras instead of just 4, for example. Okay, so to do this, from the status overview page on the web GUI, we'll go down to network and operation mode. Then where it says wired WAN port role, select wired WAN port, access LAN, and then save and apply. It's as simple as that. Now your wired WAN port is ready to be used as a LAN. You can also check if this was successful by going up to status and then down to network and then click on LAN. We scroll down a little bit. Under LAN ports, we can now see that the wired WAN is acting as a LAN port. To change the wired WAN back is pretty much the same as before. Down to network, operation mode, and then select wired WAN, access WAN, and save and apply. Next, we'll look at how to change the LAN interfaces to act as WANs. You can do this on any of the LAN interfaces, and you can have several of the LANs set to WANs at any time if you want. You can use this to have several connections to different networks, so maybe one connection to the NBN and another connection to a CM685V6 router, or several other connections to different routers. You could then set up load balancing across these routers to improve your network performance. Okay, to set this up, go to Network and then down to Switch. And add a new VLAN. You can change the ID of this new VLAN, but I'm just going to leave it as 3. So here port 0 to 3 correspond to the LAN ports, and port 4 is the wired WAN. I'm going to change the second gigabit Ethernet port to a WAN, which corresponds to port 3. So under VLAN 3, we'll change port 3 to untag, and under VLAN 1, we'll change port 3 to off. And then we'll hit save and apply. To finish adding the LAN interface as a WAN, go to Network, Interfaces, and click Add New Interface. Enter a name for the new interface. I'm just going to call this WAN 2. Select the protocol that you want to use. I'm going to use DHCP client, and then choose ETH 0.3 and press Submit. From here, go to Firewall Settings. And then choose WAN, and then save and apply. This will then take you back to the interface overview, and we can see down here, this is our WAN 2 interface that we just created. Now this interface is ready to be connected to another network or another router, and you can set up failover and load balancing, which we've covered in another video. To change it back, just click delete on the interface that you want to change back. And then change the VLANs back to how they were before. Okay, so now we've covered both how to change a WAN port into a LAN port and how to change a LAN port into a WAN port. Thank you all for watching. See you in the next video.